In addition to helping you receive notifications, copy files, and collect data, Microsoft Flow can also help you streamline your approval processes. Let's imagine that you're the manager of a team, and you ask your employees to create vacation requests in a SharePoint list. Now, you want to build an approval process around these list items so that new vacation requests are quickly processed, and the person requesting the vacation is automatically notified. In this video, we'll show you how you can quickly build such an approval workflow using the Flow integration in SharePoint lists. So what I have here is a SharePoint list for vacation requests. Notice that I have 5 columns in my list: a title to describe the vacation request, the start date, the end date, and any relevant comments about that vacation, as well as another column for status, whether it's been approved or not. Now, what I want to do to create a flow is I'm going to click on the Flow button here, and then select the Create a Flow option. This brings up the Flow panel on the right-hand side of the page. From here, I can click on various templates, like sending a customized email when a new list item is added, sending an approval email when a new item is added. I can also wait for events in other systems. For example, if a new message is posted in a Yammer group, I can create a list item for it. Or if a new lead or an account or an opportunity is created in CRM, I can create a new list item here in the SharePoint list. I can also copy tweets, and I can also post messages on Slack when a new list item is added to a specific list. If none of these options suit my needs, I can also use the two templates at the bottom, which allow me to execute a custom action, either when a new list item is added or when an existing list item is modified. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to select the second template, which sends an approval email when a new item is added. This opens up the flow.microsoft.com site and also takes us to the template landing page. Now, from this page, I can see a detailed description of the template and what it requires. So in this case, this template is for processing approvals on SharePoint list items. Once an item is approved, the item creator is sent a confirmation email. I can also view the credentials that are going to be used in this flow. If everything looks good, I'm going to go ahead and click Continue. So the first thing I notice when this flow opens is that the site URL and the list name are automatically populated for me. Now, what we're doing in this template is when a new item is created, I first send an approval email. Once that approval email is sent, and if I get an approve, I then send an email back to the person that requested that vacation item, letting them know that their vacation has been approved. So I'm going to go ahead and modify this template. So in the to line, I'm going to put in my own name. I'm also going to modify the body of this email and include more details about that item in SharePoint. So instead of saying, please approve this item, let's just say, please approve this vacation request. Let's include the title. Let's also include the vacation start date and the vacation end date. Now, notice this dynamic content dialog on the right-hand side. All of these columns, or all of these tokens that you see, map to columns that were in our SharePoint list. So for example, we see things like comments, we see things like title, start date, end date, approved. All of these map directly back to the list that I was on. So in this case, let me go ahead and complete the body. So please approve this vacation request. Here's the title from, and let's include the start date, to, and let's include the end date. And let's just throw in the comments as well. Okay. Now I'll go ahead and modify the send email step slightly as well. Instead of saying item, let's just say vacation request approved. Then let's include details about the vacation request. So let's go in with the title. And in the body, let's just keep the body the same. What I'll also do is I'll go ahead and add another action for updating the SharePoint list. So I'll go ahead and click Update Item. Here, select this SharePoint item here. For the site URL, I'll just include the site URL of my original list. And in the list name, I'll just go with Vacation Requests. for the ID. I'll select the ID of the item that was just added, and I'll keep the title the same. And let's also keep the start date and the end date the same as well. And in the approval column now, approved column, we'll change this date to say yes. And then we'll do the same thing for the no branch as well. We'll first add a step that sends an email. So here we'll type in send email. And we'll send it to the person that originally created the item. And we'll just say vacation request rejected. And we'll just throw in the title. And then for the body, we'll say the same thing. We'll just say vacation request rejected. Please select another date. And then we'll add another action that updates the item in SharePoint, but this time we'll set the approved column to the value of no. So I've typed in my list, and I've also typed in my site URL for the ID. I'll just use the ID column here. For the title, again, I'll use the title. And I'll also go ahead and populate the start date and the end date, just like I did earlier. In this case, go for end date. And this time around, let's set approved. Let's set the status to no. And that's all I need to do. I'll go ahead and click create flow. OK, now that the flow has been created, let me switch over to my SharePoint list and create a new item. Let's type in vacation request for, let's say, Sydney. So vacation request to Sydney. And let's say I'm going to be traveling from the 21st of November to, let's say, the 28th of November. You know, going to catch some sun and maybe a game of cricket. And let's hit save. Now I'm going to switch over to my inbox, and I should see a vacation request. And there I have it. So I see there was an approval request. Please approve this vacation request to Sydney from, and if I look at the dates, it maps to what I'd entered in to my SharePoint list from the 21st of November to the 28th of November. It also includes the comments. I'm going to go ahead and approve this vacation request. As soon as the vacation request is approved, the person that originally requested the item, which is me in this case, gets another email saying the vacation was approved. And if I switch back to SharePoint and refresh this, I should see the approved column now updated to say yes. So in this video, we showed you how you can use Microsoft Flow and our integration with SharePoint to very easily create an approval workflow around your data.